friends, I am Ravi Narayan Acharya from Gujarat Ayurveda University, Jamnagar. Today, I will be discussing regarding the evidence of pharmacovigilance in Ayurvedic literature. So, as we all know, pharmacovigilance is the science and activities related to detection, assessment, understanding and prevention, adverse effect or any other drug related problems. This drug related problem being further defined as issues that affect the safety and safe use of medicine. As we all know, drugs are double-edged weapons. They save several lives, at the same time produce adverse effects ranging from mild skin eruption to death. Safety and efficacy are the two major concerns about any drugs. Efficacy of a drug can be detected with relative case. The same cannot be said about safety. With this, gave birth to a new branch of science called pharmacovigilance. The domain of pharmacovigilance includes the entire period of journey of medicine and related products from the pre-approval development to the post-approval period. So, the goal of the pharmacovigilance is foster the rational and safe use of medicines. There are various terms used in the pharmacovigilance, and the most common terms are adverse drug reactions, commonly known as ADR, which is defined as a response to a medicine which is noxious and unintended and which occurs at dose normally used in man. Another common terms used in pharmacovigilance is adverse event. That says that is defined as any untoward medical occurrence that may present during treatment with a pharmaceutical product, but which does not necessarily have a causal relationship with treatment. And another common definitions, which is of a technical term used in pharmacovigilance, is the side effect. Side effect is defined as any unintended effect of a pharmaceutical product occurring at dose normally used by a patient which is related to the pharmacological properties of the drugs. Dear friends, here the word any unintended effect of a pharmaceutical product, but in case of adverse drug reactions, that is a response to a medical which is noxious, though in case of adverse drug reaction it is unintended, but the word noxious is there in case of adverse drug reactions. So, the adverse drug reactions is that one which has always noxious effect. We got some noxious actions of the drugs, but in case of side effect, that is only unintended pharmaceutical product having, that is normally used by both positive and negative effect may be taken there. And another term used in pharmacovigilance is the signal. Signal is defined as a reported information on a possible causal relationship between an adverse event and a drug, the relationship being unknown or incompletely documented previously. The technical term de-challenge and re-challenge are also used for assessment of adverse drug reactions, and the de-challenge is defined as the withdrawal of a drug from a patient, continuity, reduction or disappearance of adverse effect may be observed at this point, whereas re-challenge, the point at which a drug is again given to a patient after its previous withdrawal. So, a reporter to whom we will call a reporter in pharmacovigilance program, a healthcare professional reporting ADR on the ADR form is called as a reporter. An investigator is a person or a healthcare professional involved in the investigation of drug-related adverse reaction. And in the previous lecture, we have discussed in detail about why we need pharmacovigilance programs, and we have also discussed the need of pharmacovigilance programs for Ayurveda Siddha Yunani drugs. I am not going to say in detail about that, but today we'll try to know that how this evidence of pharmacovigilance is vibrant in the different text, classical text of Ayurveda. The classical text describes a drug will be harmful as that of a poison, a sharp weapon or fire or thunderbolt if not understood properly and if administered improperly. That yathavishang, yathasastrang, yathagni, sarijyatha, tatha, osadham vigyatang, vigyatang, amrutang, yatha. A drug must be understood in a proper way, otherwise, if not understood in a proper way and if administered, it will act as a poison only. Another important information regarding pharmacovigilance concern of the drugs is regarding the administration, the dose, which differentiate a dose from a poison, drug from a poison, is that a potent poison becomes a drug on proper administration. On the other hand, if in a best drug become a poison if he used incorrectly. So, Ayurveda tells, yogadapi visham tiknam muttabam bhesajam bhavet bhesajam tavi duritam tiknam sampaddate visham. That a drug, a poison, if administered in a proper dose, can act as a best drug on the other hand, a drug, if administered in a wrong way or in the high dose, it can become a poison. That for Ayurveda also gives information about an ideal drug. An ideal drug is that which pacifies the disease but does not produce or provoke any untoward effect. Prayoga samyak vyadhin samudhirayat. That is, a drug is a good which does not cause other disease conditions. If it causes some other disease conditions, then it should not be considered as a good drugs. That is the concept, that modern pharmacovigilance, the concept of pharmacovigilance, a drug for the purpose, for which purpose that has been intended, must be act that only. If it has other function, then that won't be called as a drug. And in the concept describing about a drug action, and a physician to make a physician best, it is told that a physician who is vigilant throughout the treatment protocol with regards to patients and different stage of the disease, he never get confused in diagnosis and treatment. Mohar moscha roganam avastha maturasyatya. So a physician must be vigilant throughout the treatment protocol. So Ayurveda does not say that a new drug when administered should be monitored in the first phase or post clinical trial in the fourth phase all that way. But Ayurveda tells the drug, whenever the drug is in the market, whenever the drug, how old that is, it may be a drug of Vedic origin or a drug of recently trial from traditional medicine, from tribal claims or that new drug or old drug, whenever the drug is in the market, whenever the drug is in use, a physician must be vigilant during the treatment protocol, and that thing Ayurveda very categorically says regarding the importance of the pharmacovigilance there, that how efficient to be vigilant throughout the treatment. Further, regarding the side effects, categorization of the ADRs, Ayurveda says that ADRs are prone to be precipitated. When the drug is administered in more or less quantity, administered at inappropriate time, inappropriately processed drug or improperly metabolized in the body. Shears have mentioned that caution also needs to be exercised when selecting a suitable specific dosage forms which are useful in selective conditions. In another version, it is being told that contraindications for drug therapies have been indicated, particularly the patients that are not suitable for Pamana, Virichana and Basti. Even the age limit has been given in case of Panchakarma procedures. So, here in the modern pharmacovigilance system, they have started with the drug first. They include pharmacovigilance for drugs. Then they include pharmacovigilance for the procedures, instrument. Now everything has been step by step, they are including the pharmacovigilance in the purview of pharmacovigilance. But you see the beauty of Ayurveda literature, in thousands years back also, they not only include about the drugs, the concern of the drugs, how it should be administered, how the physician should be vigilant, they also mentioned regarding the pharmacovigilant concern of the procedures. And it is very astounding to see that Charaka has dedicated a chapter in Kalpastana, that is Panchakarma Vyapat. So there they mention if the persons who are indicated for Vamana, Virechana and Basti, and what are the probable adverse effect will occur if the Panchakarma procedure if not administered properly, and what are the adverse effects if the instruments used during the Panchakarma are not properly designed or properly administered or properly inserted. A clear contraindications is given as per Sadrasa Sevana, which leads to maldevelopment of upcoming baby. In gynecological disorders, in case of genetic things also, Ayurveda gives much emphasis to the diet. For a pregnant, what are the do's and don'ts of a pregnant woman has been very clearly mentioned in the classical text of Ayurveda. And Masanumasika Paricharya has also been good advice for the pregnant women. And there, which are the rasa? There are six rasa, madhura, amla, lavana, katu, tikta, kasaya. And which rasa should be taken, which not to be taken, which should be taken in the more quantity, which is to be avoided, and which condition that is to be avoided, everything has been clearly mentioned in the classical text. This shows a novel approach for pharmacovigilance for judging the ADRs. In case of Snihana Karma, Vagvata has also advised to start the dose from small quantity and to monitor the digestion of patients and then switch over to the larger dose of the ghee. This shows that at that point of time, the dose and the administration purpose, the detailed pharmacovigilance concern of the Panchakarma procedures has also been noted. The do's and don'ts, that is pathya-pathya, have been quoted in case of food in convalescence period of the diseases. When the pathya-pathya, a beautiful concept of Ayurveda, also gives a hint towards the pharmacovigilance concern for the good management of the patients. There, which diet are provocative, which diets are supportive, that has been well described in the classical text. Description and management of ADR occurring during various therapeutic processes have been vividly stated. The food drug and drug-drug incompatibility have been delineated by Charaka. The concept of Viruddhahara is a unique example of vigilance. As we have discussed in the previous lecture that Ayurveda has a very clear-cut guideline regarding drug and drug diet, and they have given example. There are a good number of examples which says that how the drug, if taken with certain drugs, or if some drugs are combined together or mixed with other drugs, are harmful to the body. What are the adverse reactions to be produced, adverse effects to be produced if they are consumed, and they have concept of they have, and that is known as Viruddha Ahara concept, and how they have given that what the cord not to be taken in the copper vessel, and other many items that the cords to be not taken in the night time, and if taken, how it is to be taken, all these things has been given in a very good example, with good examples. So that is there in the Ayurvedic text. Certain specific combination of drugs with special reference to the dose, constitution, habitat, preparation procedures can result into deleterious effects. 17 types of such incompatibility have been described by Charaka. So, in Swastamutta, there are 17 different types of incompatibilities, that is, Viruddha has also been described by Charaka. Certain factors like Dushya, Desha, Bala, Kala, Prakruti, Agni, Vaya have to be taken into consideration before planning the treatment regimen to avoid side effects. As Ayurveda considers many factors before administration of the drug, a drug dose is not the only factor, and the decision of the dose is also related to the other factors like the Dushya, Desha, Bala, Kala and Prakruti, Agni and Vaya of the patients. So all these factors are, if considered in a proper way, judiciously by the physician, there is very less chance or even if no chance of any side effect during the treatment. Purification procedures for herbal, minerals, aquatic, metallic preparations have been widely described in and well discussed. Ayurveda uses drugs of poisonous nature, and the poisonous has also been categorized as Visha and Upavisha. So there, the purification methods of this poisonous plants has been well described. If these poisonous plants or the metallic and mineral preparations are not properly detoxified, not properly processed, then there is chance of adverse effect. In case of metals, minerals like mercury, mica, sulfur, arsenic, lead, probable toxic symptoms and their management have been elaborately explained in the classical Rasagrantha. This can be correlated with the vigilance in good manufacturing practice. As in the lecture for this drug standardization, we discuss regarding the good manufacturing practices. So this shodhana, this processing, upaskritam, that is considered, if not processed properly, then there is every chance of adverse effects of the drugs. Side effects for prolonged use of certain drugs like pipali, kshara have been described. Certain drugs, pipali is considered one of the best medicines in Ayurveda, but at the same time, it has been clearly noted that pipali should not be taken, consumed for long durations. And at the same time, certain particular the kshara, the alkali preparations, has been advocated khyara and labana not to be taken for longer period. Even if Chakrapani, while commenting on amalaki, a drug like amalaki, if consumed in higher doses, can result agnimandya, this has been noted also. various nighantus and describes many plants with adverse effect, and there are probable adverse effect of many plants has been described. A few among them, as we consider, that is the gugulu. Gugulu, though a very common plant, it's and most very vividly written, and the preparations of gugulu for management of joint disorders and many other disease conditions, the adverse effect of the gugulu has been well documented. And more, the it is being clearly observed in the classical text that the more the use of the drug, more their adverse reporting of their adverse effect in the classical text of Ayurveda. Take the example of rasuna. Rasuna, there has been chapter dedicated in certain text regarding the adverse effect of rasuna, and chapter dedicated regarding the clinically efficiency or different indications of rasuna. But at the same time, the adverse effect of rasuna has been well documented in the classical text of Ayurveda. One of the best drug is in the Agrevarga comes the Haritaki. Haritaki, at all the same time, Haritaki has been well documented and for its various therapeutic efficacy, even if it is considered as a best pathya among Haritaki pathyanam in the Charak Samhita. But at the same time, Bhavprakash notes its adverse contraindications of Haritaki, to whom it has been clearly mentioned that Haritaki should not be given to the old aged persons, the pregnant women, and certain season conditions. There are many examples. Take the example of Surana. Surana has been considered as the Shrestha Shaka Kanda. Among the Kanda Shaka, Surana has been considered as the best one. But at the same time, the contraindications of Surana has been also been noted in the classical text of Ayurveda. This gives an example. All these plants drugs must be considered as an exemplary way, and all other drugs, when they are prescribed with new conditions, some new preparations along with the other drugs, their observations must be noted and must be propagated for the benefit of the treatment procedures. So these are the certain and adverse drug effect reports in the various classical texts of Ayurveda. Then we will discuss regarding this particular slide shows you some more informations available in the various classical texts, particularly the nighantus. We have adverse events, adverse effect reported in the classic nighantu, like Bhavprakash nighantu, Madanapala nighantu, Raja nighantu, Kayadava nighantu, they have. And we can classify them that these are the drugs which provoke the vata, doshic provocations. These are the medicinal plants which affect certain organs, and these are the medicinal plants affect certain dhatus. So in case of dosha, dhatu, mala, the reporting of the effect of individual drugs has been well documented, and this link gives you certain published documents, published research articles regarding reporting of adverse event of certain medicinal plants described in classical text of Ayurveda. So with this, today the information available on pharmacovigilance in different classical texts of Ayurveda